Hello, and welcome to Bay College's video lectures for Math 085. Today, we're going to look at section 1.9, which is the adding of integers. And as we've seen in the previous video, integers just include the positive and the negative values, the values to the right of 0 and the values to the left of 0. Now, when we add or subtract, some of us might have to take a new mindset. We can't think of addition and subtraction in the same terms anymore when we deal with negative numbers. One way we can think of it is positive, it means to move to the right on the number line. And negative means to move to the left on the number line. So we can't think of it as addition or subtraction, but more of a direction on a number line. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to look at adding using our number line 4 plus 3. These integers are both positive, positive 4, positive 3. And if I add them on a number line, well, I start left to right. Here's my point of reference. I'm going to start at 4, and I'm going to add 3. Well, I'm going to start at 4, and I'm going to go to the right 3 units. So if I find 4 on my number line, it's right here. And then I'm going to go 3 units to the right. I'm adding 3. 1, 2, 3 units. Here I am. And if I count how many units away I am, I'm 7 units away. Well, that kind of makes sense because 4 plus 3 is 7. What if the integers are both negative? If we look at this, we have negative 2, and we're going to add negative 3. Now, all these signs may be a little intimidating initially, but let's think of it in a new light. My reference, I'm going to start at negative 2. And then I'm going to combine that by going to the left 3. So we think of it in terms of direction instead of addition or subtraction. So I'm going to start at negative 2. So I go 2 spots. I'm going to start right here. And then I'm going to combine it with negative 3, which means go to the left 3 spots. 1, 2, 3. Now this value here, if I count from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This would be negative because it's to the left of 0, and it's 5 units away, negative 5. So I start at negative 2, and I go to negative 3, or negative 3 more, excuse me, by using the concept of direction. Now, another thing we're going to look at is what this actually means. And we'll see that on the next board a little bit. We're going to do these 4 examples, and then we're going to concentrate on a few of them. The first one, we have 15 plus 12. Both of these integers are positive integers. And because they have the same sign and they're both positive, I'm just going to stay to the right of 0. So I'm going to start at 15 and go to the right 12. Well, if I do that, that's the addition that we've come to know very well. 15 and 12 is going to give me 27. Because I combined 2 positive integers, I got a larger positive integer. If we look at this example, I'm going to start at negative 5, and then I'm going to combine it by going left 6 on our number line. Well, since both of these values are negative, this addition, we don't think of it as addition. We think of it as combining these two terms. Well, if I'm to the left of 0 and I go further left, my answer should be left of 0 or negative. So we can do an assessment before we begin when it comes to these negative integers. And we can determine the sign before we actually find the value. So I know I'm going to stay left of 0 because I'm starting left of 0, and I'm going further left of 0. So I know it's going to be a negative. But if we think about it, since they are both left of 0, and one takes me further left of 0, I just combine them. Negative 5 and negative 6 is a negative 11. 5 and 6 is 11. Both are negative, so we get to negative 11. What if they have different signs? If we visualize, mentally visualize our number line, we can start at negative 2, and this says add 4, or combine it with a positive 4. So I'm going to start at negative 2 and go 4 units to the right. Well, if I go 1 unit, I'm at negative 1. 1 more unit, I'm at 0. 1 more unit, I'm at positive 1. 1 more unit, I'm at positive 2. So this gives me positive 2 if I visualize my number line and look at these in terms of direction. Start at negative 2, go to the right 4. And that would bring me to 2. Well, what about this one here? 7 plus a negative 10. Well, that's saying combine 7 by going left 10. So 7, if I started at 7 on my number line and went left 10 units, that's quite a few units. Well, 7 of those units would get me to 0. And we know the difference of 7 and 10 is 3. So I'd have to go 3 more units to the left. Well, that brings me left of 0. And one way to determine the sign before you begin is just do a little assessment. I'm only adding here. I'm combining integers. Well, the 10 is the larger value. If they have different signs, the larger value will always determine the sign. And I'll elaborate more on that a little bit more. So essentially, what I'm going to find is the difference. And we'll explain that in 1.10 or 1.10. But 7 and then going left 10 brings me to negative 3 on my number line. All right, well, let's look at how these can be defined a little bit differently. One way to look at it is do an assessment of the problem you're working on. If the values have the same sign, they are both to the right of 0 or they are both to the left of 0, combine them and keep their signs. So same sign, combine. It's like a little rhyme, right? Same sign, combine. If we look at this, we had 15 and 12. They were the same sign. We combined them to get a larger positive value. Positive gave me a positive because they were both positive values. Same sign, we combine. This one, each of our integers both had the same sign. So I combined them and I kept that sign, negative 11. So that's one way to look at it. When they have different signs, we're going to find the difference. Different signs find the difference. But here's where we have to be very careful and always assess. The largest value is the one that determines the sign of our answer. It has the sign. So if we look at this one, we had negative 2 and we had positive 4. And when we combine these, well, they had different signs, so I found the difference. What's the difference of 4 and 2? Well, the difference of 4 and 2 is 2. Well, the 4 was positive, so my answer is positive. And that's what we found, a positive 2. The difference of 4 and 2 is 2. The larger value is positive, so it is a positive 2. If we look at these two, we say, OK, well, this was a positive 7. When there's no sign out there, we assume it's positive. And we combined it with a negative 10, so we went left 10. Well, if they have the different signs, I'm just going to find the difference. The difference of 7 and 10 is 3. Well, is it a positive 3 or negative 3? I look and say, well, the larger value was negative, so my answer is negative. And that's what we got, a negative 3. So always keep this in mind. Same sign, combine, keep that sign. Different signs, find the difference. The larger value will determine the difference. All right, our next example is 32 plus a negative 8. Well, we can think of that as 32 combined with a negative 8. So I'm going to start at 32, and I'm going to go 8 units to the left. That's what that negative says. To the left. Well, if I go to the left of 32, 8 units, that's going to bring me to 24. So 24 is the answer. Here I have negative 21, and I'm going to combine that with a positive 9. Well, they have different signs. I've made that assessment. Different signs, find the difference. The difference of 21 and 9 is 12. Is it a positive 12 or a negative 12? Well, the larger value was negative, so my answer is negative. If we look at these two, well, I see different signs, but it's that special case of 0. Is it positive or negative? Well, 0 is that special case. It's either or neither. So negative 5, if I add nothing to it, it will remain negative 5. But we do that negative 5 plus 0. Let's just look at 5 and 0. If we find their difference is 5. But it's a negative 5 because 5 is larger than 0. Same thing, right? We didn't change it at all. We added nothing to it. All right, let's look at this right here. If we recall opposites, opposites are just changing the sign of the number. If I want to know the opposite of a negative number, it is its positive. If I have its positive, I change its negative to get its opposite. Well, let's think about this here. 8 plus a negative 8. Well, if I have 8 plus a negative 8, I can also think of it as if I start at 8 and I'm going to go left 8, that's the same thing as subtraction. 8 minus 8 is 0. So this concept says if I have a number's opposite, combining a number with its opposite will result in 0. All right, let's return with this concept that 8 plus a negative 8 is the same as subtraction. Let's return to this example over here. We had this 32 plus a negative 8 equals 24. Well, if I have 32 and I'm going to add the opposite of 8, well, adding the opposite is the same thing as subtraction. So this might be a tool that's going to help you. If you see opposite signs here, it says we're going to combine it with its opposite. That's subtraction. The opposite of combining would be taking away. 32 minus 8 will give us 24. The same result. So if you see something like this, maybe you want to change it to that because you're familiar with that operation. So this is part 1 of 1.9. Please continue on to watch part 2. Thank you.